They're a prehistoric fish. They're around the same time as the dinosaurs. They're often mistaken for sharks with people that don't know that there aren't sharks in the Great Lakes. That is a young of year sturgeon. It would probably be about 4 to 6 months in age. And unfortunately, those are pretty uncommon for us to find in these river systems.
A lot of the natural habitat in the Detroit and St. Clair rivers was removed for channelization to bring in freighters, you know, to build the cities. But most of the habitat was also good fish spawning habitat. So with the decline of that good habitat, we see a precipitous decline of the fish species.
What we're doing is building sturgeon spawning habitat, and actually not just sturgeon, but walleye and lake whitefish. These are species we haven't seen in the Detroit River in decades. We're putting rock in the water just off of Belle Isle, which is right at the head of the Detroit River. It's limestone rock. It's angular, sort of 4 to 8 inches in size.
June of 2004, we put in the first three reefs, essentially postage stamps compared to what we're doing now. They were a few hundred square meters in size versus several acres that we're putting in now.
These sturgeon are suffering a really high mortality. In some rivers, they have estimates of 99.9% mortalities of larval fish before they even develop into those 6-inch young of year.
We work real closely with the shipping industry, with the Coast Guard, and those different agencies that deal with navigation, etc. This reef itself is being put off channel, so that's not become an impediment to shipping in any way, shape, or form.
Lake sturgeon are really unique, especially among fish in the Great Lakes. Given their large size, they can get to be 6 to 7 feet in length, upwards of 80 to 100 pounds.
The coolest thing about this whole reef project will be next spring when we see sturgeon, walleye, and suckers out there spawning. We know that we've had a real impact on the region, the ecosystem, and the economy.